Hello and welcome to another video. Today I am doing a Sephora try-on haul. So the things I have to supplement that I didn't get from this haul, I'll try to make them also from Sephora just so we are cohesive and let's go. Okay.
Hi. It's Holly on the couch. I was editing the video and I realized there is a crackle throughout a lot of the video, and that is from my microphone, and I will try to figure out what's going on there, but I just wanted to quickly apologize because it's annoying, but I worked hard on the video and it's a longer video, so I didn't want to do a voiceover, so please forgive me and I will do better. Okay, enjoy the rest of the video.
I picked up the Merit Great Skin Instant Glow Serum. Shake well. Massage 2 to 3 pumps onto skin before or after moisturizer. Use in the morning or twice a day. Merit is like who I want to be. You know, minimalist, but I'm not, okay? I am going to take 2 pumps. It is just a straight up liquid.
It feels like
an oil. And that works for me because I have dry to dehydrated skin and it feels slippy, like foundation is going to sit well on top. Of course, the packaging is glass. It's really beautiful. And this is my second time using it underneath makeup. The first time I used it, spoiler alert, it was amazing. And I got a little sample of the K-Skin Isle Glow Face Lotion. SPF 45, so I'm going to put this on next as my moisturizer for the day.
Sun shines
all year round, and you can see there's a tint to this one, so I need to take it all the way down. But the formula is thin, and there's no light cast because of the tint, and it is leaving my skin with a nice glow. This was a heavy complexion buy for me. I picked up 3 complexion products. I picked up the House Labs Triclone Foundation. I actually got this shade 050 Fair Cool, and it is a little warm on me, so I have 040 coming in the mail. But I have heard through the grapevine that this is like MAC foundation, so you want to get the opposite of what you are. So if you have pale pink cool undertones, then you want to get the foundation that calls itself warm. Totally confusing. When I swatched this in store, it felt dry as a bone on my hand, and I was like, I'm absolutely not buying that. And I heard more and more people with dry skin talk about how they really enjoyed it. So during the sale, I was like, okay, you got me. House Labs, you got me. So I purchased and I wore it in one of the most recent Get Ready With Me's on my Instagram. And it looked beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I did wear the Merit Great Skin underneath. Maybe that helped, but it lasted all day. It didn't settle into the creases of my nose. It didn't make my smile lines and the fine lines on my forehead emphasized. So whatever, House Labs wins. Okay, I admit it, it's good. If you can find your shade, which there are 50 shades, range is not the problem. It's navigating the range. I also picked up the Iconic London Super Smoother Blurring Skin Tint. This was a Julia Adams influence. Okay, she tried this and it looked amazing on her skin, so I'm really excited to try it. It's the one I'm going to be going in with today. I also got the Blurring Underglow Primer from Iconic, so we'll be doing that. I also picked up the Westman Atelier Vital Skin Foundation Stick. I love Westman Atelier products, so I wanted to try the foundation. I picked up Atelier Zero, and it might be a little deep for me. I haven't played with it yet, but for haul purposes, that's the haul, y'all. So I'm going to start out with the Underglow Blurring Primer. Another glass bottle, shake well before use, if you say so. And it is a dropper.
I have to zoom you in so you can see. But I do feel like it's making my pores look a little less crazy.
I don't mind.
Pores. Oh, it feels like silk. It feels like silk sheets just gliding across your face.
And it smells like, it has like a hint of baby powder smell to it, which I actually like the smell of baby powder. So it doesn't bother me. But I could totally see myself wearing this without makeup. It looks so nice. Okay. It looks beautiful. I need some lip balm. Please hold. All right. Lips have been balmed. Next, the Super Smoother Blurring Skin Tint. The packaging. And it is a plastic bottle, and it is a whopping 1 fluid ounce. I got the shade Cool Fair, and it has like a medium viscosity. It's not super liquidy, but it's not thick, but you can see it's not running down my finger. It has the same like silky texture as the blurring primer, so that's exciting. Going to do one side with a flat kabuki style brush. This shade is perfecto. Yeah. So I am getting like streak marks with the brush. So it may be one that I spread out with a brush and then go over with a sponge. For science sake, I will take a damp sponge and apply the skin tint, which of course is giving me a little bit more of a sheer coverage, but not really, you know, drastically. It is just a skin tint after all. So here is brush, one layer, and here is sponge, one layer. And I'm going to add more. I'm going to see if I can build it up. Once again, for science sake, I'm just going to use whatever was left on the palette. I'm not going to squeeze out any more. I really mess with a sheer to light coverage base product. I really do. It's typically what I go for. Even if I use a full coverage product, I will like thin it out or wear something super dewy underneath. So totally my vibe. So it's not settling in the crack of my nose, but I do have some dryness right here that it is sitting on top of. And mind you, I have an oil, a sunscreen, and a primer underneath, so those three things could either be a negative or a positive combination. This is first impressions, of course, so be sure to check out my Instagram for more trial and error, basically, because that's all that this is. Trial and error. Almost every time I do my makeup, it's trial and error. It's like, you know, Forrest Gump's box of chocolates. I never know what I'm going to get. Sweet tea. I'm from the South. In the concealer category, I picked up two concealers. I picked up the little mini version of the Tarte Power Flex, Tarte C Collection Power Flex Concealer. I picked up Fair Beige 12B. It had just been a long time since I tried anything Tarte, and I was curious. I also wore it in said Instagram Get Ready With Me, and it worked really well, so go Tarte. And this is a Khaki Reviews Beauty Influence. It is the Kaja Don't Settle Flexible and Seamless Concealer. I picked up the shade 01 Sweet Rice. Let's see. Does this have any like special claims? Oh yes. Flexible, elastic formula, seamless, natural finish, moisturizing, buildable coverage, can be used as a targeted concealer or all over face.
Brilliant.
Love it. Okay, Khaki really likes this concealer, and I like most things that Khaki likes, so ooh, it's thinner than I expected it to be. I don't know why, but it is pretty liquidy, and I like that. I love the packaging. It is plastic, but I like this blue color so much. I'm gonna blend out with a brush.
Okay, what brush is this? This is a brightening concealer brush from Real Techniques.
And it is very fluffy. I heard that this brightening concealer brush was a dupe for the Angie Hot and Flashy by BK Beauty. They are the same shape, but BK is more dense, so when I push down on my finger, you can see the bristles don't move very much, and then when I push down with my finger here, the bristles are moving. So it's not an exact dupe, but it is a pretty good alternative. And that concealer blended out A+ spectacular.
I am not a full coverage kind of girl.
I am over 30. I have just embraced my face being my face. You know what I mean? Like, yes, I have freckles. Yes, I have pores. You have pores. Yes, I have imperfections. You have imperfections. Yes, I have wrinkles on my forehead because, you know, I really thought I would be the one. The one person on the planet to just not age past a certain point, but it's not me, okay? It's someone else. And I'm just going to age. And a lot of people talk about aging gracefully and whatever. It's not going to be graceful. I'm just going to age. And it's going to be fine. And you know what's more than fine? This concealer. I need my close-up. I am a fan. What I'm going to do is add just a touch more and build it up to see if it's that kind of thing where I put it around my nose and chin over that skin tint where the skin tint was kind of emphasizing the dry areas I had. It made my skin look better. So you really can't ask for too much more.
Oh, it did build.
And I could definitely see myself, as they suggest on the packaging, wearing this with no foundation underneath. So all I would need is this Iconic London Blurring Primer and then put on some of the Don't Settle Concealer. And then no one could talk to me for the rest of the day because I would just be too much. All right, and to set that concealer in place, I'm going to take my Rare Beauty powder, one of my favorites. I'm going to use a floofy brush and really work all the powder in the cap into the brush. Just take a tippy tap of the finger and a tippy tap of the powder, making sure I get it in my brows as well. So the brow product I go in with sticks to my skin. Go around my nose creases and my mouth creases and my chin creases. Okay, that is a super tiny amount of powder. Recommend this one from Rare Beauty. It's beautiful. All right, and today I'm going to be bronzing my skin with the Ilia Drawn In Nightlight Bronzing Powder.
Did not get this in the sale. I already have it. So
I did not powder around the perimeter of my face. So at first I am going to just like use tapping motions to place this onto my skin. And as you can see, it is pretty pigmented and it's also fairly neutral. I have bronzers that definitely are much warmer than this and much cooler than this.
I'm gonna take the excess on the brush down the neck and check.
Okay, done with that, I suppose. My brush just like yeet right out of my hand. And I'm going to take the same little brush I used to powder my under eyes and just take it around the perimeter. I did not add any extra product to it, but I really want that bronzer to be seamless, taking the excess and blending out the edges of the bronzer.
And I have a new blush from Patrick Ta. New to me, this is the Monochrome Moment Velvet Blush in the shade She's Seductive. And as we can see, also fairly neutral, leaning more cool. And blush for me, one of those makeup steps where I will add it knowing that I might need to add more once the look is finished. I like to add blush on my nose. And also up here on the forehead.
That is beautiful. I love that.
I wonder, my brain, when I saw this Patrick Ta blush on my skin, I was like, reminds me of Flirtatious from Patrick Ta, from Pat McGrath. Patrick Ta, Pat McGrath. Let's do swatches. So, I'm gonna swatch Flirtatious, which is beautiful, one of my favorite powder blushes. And I'm gonna swatch She's Seductive right below it.
You guys! They're the same! They're the same! So, I'm not sure if it's any more affordable than Pat McGrath, but Flirtatious from Pat McGrath and She's Seductive from Patrick Ta, they're the same. No wonder when I put this on my skin, I'm like, wow, that looks really great, because girl, you have it already in your collection. But that was sent in PR, so that's crazy. How exciting. Okay.
Dupe, but not necessarily a more affordable dupe, just a dupe.
Great. And the only powder highlighter that I have from Sephora is the House Labs highlighter in the shade Sunstone. I'm gonna take that on a floofy brush. Definitely has some golden tones to it, which I'm kind of trying to go more cool tone. I can make it work. These highlighters from House Labs are super pretty, and admittedly they're not something that I wanted to like, but I do like the gel, like baked gelée kind of formula. Moving on to eyeshadow, I picked up the Makeup by Mario palette. Okay, this is the Ethereal Eyes palette, and this is a metal palette, whereas his other one is plastic. I only have the Master Matte's palette, and I use it all the time. That's why it's like first in the line here in my little bookshelf of palettes. And just let's take a moment to appreciate the basicness of this palette. Okay, talk about everyday palette. Talk about a beautiful gift for someone who works in an office. A beautiful gift for a teenager. Pricey gift, sure, but beautiful nonetheless. And of course, I mean, if I'm honest, I only bought this because of the 20% off sale, but I have a feeling that I'm not going to regret buying it. Okay, and here we go. Yes. I am going to start out with the lightest matte shade in the palette. Ooh, very powdery, which hopefully means pigment. That doesn't really bother me. And they are labeled just like they are in the other palettes. So this is the shade EE1. Okay, so it's just a pale beigey color. And it's going all over the crease, up to the brow bone. And it's been about 37 years since I've done a halo eye, so I think that's what I'm going to do. Across to the next deepest beigey color. And I'm only blowing on this palette because I am using it on myself. I don't plan on using it on anyone else. So this is EE3 going directly in the socket. And then when there's not much left on the brush, I can blend it up towards the brow. These three shades down this row, they are all topper shades. So there is not a lot of base to them. They're mostly just straight up glitter and shimmer. Think his master reflect shadows highlighters. So it's very much the same formula. And then you have two shades, this shade and this shade, that are more like metallics. So there is a base, but there's also glitter and the rest are matte. I'm going to take the shade directly beneath the first very beige shade that I used, and this one is the coolest tone in the palette, and it is EE5. I'm going to place that on the outer corners of the eye. I would love to wear this shade all by itself. I'm getting my inner socket right here really well with this gray shade, kind of flicking it up, bringing that gray higher up on the outer corner as well. They are very pigmented, they blend effortlessly. I mean, his shadows are gorgeous. I just don't know why this is limited edition. This could easily be like a core product. We all know why, right? Sales. Let's be honest. All right, I've got that applied. I can always blend more as I go. Right now, in typical halo eye fashion, or spotlight eye fashion, it's really about going back and forth, placing shadow, blending that shadow, placing more shadow, blending that shadow, etc., etc. Having said that, I am going to this shade, which is like a hot chocolate color to me, in my opinion, and it is EE4, and it is deeper than this gray that I just put on, but it also is more brown, and that's going in the exact same places that I just put shadow, just not as blown out, because I want that gray to be smoked out. Invisible again. It's gonna look like a hot mess until it doesn't. So if you are doing your own eyeshadow and you're just getting like frustrated at this point because it looks like it does at this point, keep going, okay? Keep blending, keep adding, keep editing. You will get there. And you will be glad that you didn't give up. I have a teeny tiny brush, and I am taking the deepest shade, which is EE12. Focus this on the lash line as I apply it, because I really need that depth, having such blonde lashes. Doing a patting motion before I do a blending motion is what helps me usually. If it looks like a muddy mess, you've done it right. I'm going to go back into EE3 and very gently. And on my ring finger, I'm going to take the middle shimmer shade, which is EE6. And they feel like a cream shadow in the pan. They're just so smooth. I'm patting that in the middle and overlapping a little bit into the shadows. Again, these would be magic. Just washed across the lid on their own. Try to flick some of that fallout off. Right, now I'm taking the Cali Ray Smudge Proof Eyeliner. And I'm going to just mimic the eyeshadow placement and place this in the waterline and tight line, leaving a space blank. I want to put mascara on, taking the Tower 28 Make Waves Mascara, which is a beautiful mascara. Alright, for brows, I am taking the House Labs The Edge Precision Brow Pencil in the shade Cinnamon, which is a lovely redhead shade. And to set the brows in place, a favorite that you can get at Sephora is the Kosas Airbrow Gel in the shade Auburn. I like the hold. I love the color. I love the triangular shaped brush because it really does help with precision. And for the lips, I'm taking one of my all-time favorite lip pencils. It is the Makeup by Mario lip pencil in the shade Hue. It's like my lip tone, but cooler, so I really enjoy it. I'm going over that with the Merit lipstick in the shade Baby. These lipsticks are super... silky. It's another one of those where I just want to get lost and just keep going around and around my lips. And for a touch of gloss, I am taking the Kosas Lip Oil in the shade Unhooked.
Another cool tone.
I love the vanilla orange scent on this. If you want your lips to look bigger, just put a good healthy amount of gloss right across your cupid's bow. Finally, for setting spray, I am taking the Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray from Charlotte Tilbury. I have just an inkling of this
left.
Really expensive. But it really does lock your makeup in all day. I won't be repurchasing it because I have, you know, roughly 3,000 setting sprays to get through, but it is a really good one. Smells like an old rich white lady, but thankfully the smell doesn't last all day long. And
here is the finished look using things from my Sephora sale haul.
Let me know what products you got from the Sephora sale haul. If you bought any, are you on a no buy? Real quick recap. Let's check in. Push those baby hairs down.
The only place.
Places. That are looking a little dry is around my nose cracks and on my chin. The forehead looks good. Everything looks good other than that. So it's always a case of, is it the combination of everything I just put on? Is it the product itself? So this is just a first impression try on haul, so take that with what it is, okay? But I really enjoyed using the oil. I will continue to use that in my routine. I'm gonna put it in its place. Success. I am going to have to try the Iconic London Underglow Primer and the Super Smoother Skin Tint again on their own without the Merit, This primer is blurring. Both of these products are blurring, so it might be that there is some kind of silicone in here and it's not agreeing with that oil I put on my skin. So that could be why I'm experiencing some like dryness and just some places where it looks obviously like makeup, which is definitely not what you want out of a skin tint. So, like I said, on Instagram, those will be being put to the test again. If you'd like for me to use these again in another video, just comment down below, let me know. What else did we use? Already knew about the bronzer. I really like this Patrick Ta blush. I love the formula of his blushes, and this is no exception. And it's just kind of a cool sidebar that we found that it is a color dupe for the Pat McGrath Flirtatious blush. As for the eyeshadow palette, the colors are gorgeous. The silkiness and smoothness and blendability of these shadows is really what make Mario shadows special. These topper shades are just, again, super gorgeous. Also, you know, let me know if you'd like to see just a look with one of these shades just all over the lid. I did experience fallout with the glitter shades. It wiped off the face fairly easy, but it might be a better idea to use a glitter primer or even an eyeshadow primer underneath just so they don't fall out. This color, the deepest shade, actually did get pretty deep. So that's my concern, that maybe this might not be for every skin tone. There's not a black in here, and this color, while it is pretty deep on me, it might not be on everybody. So, but like I said, he should keep this in the permanent line. It's absolutely gorgeous. Very excited. I did lean more on the cool tones today, and I would say overall this palette is more cool tone. And with the exception of this shade, and I can see that we're going to start transitioning to cool tones. It's going to be cool tones for this fall and winter. So brace yourself, okay? I forgot the Kaja concealer. I really like it. It's not creasing under my eyes. Granted, I did set it with powder, but some concealers crease even when I set them with powder. So I really like that I was able to build it up and it was easy. And that's really all I can ask for in a concealer. I want it to be easy. I don't want to have to mess around with it for 5, 10, 15 minutes, okay? So, Kaja Don't Settle Concealer. If they have a shade for you, I'd say check it out. And that's it for the newness. Everything else I already had and loved. So, if you liked this kind of video, let me know by hitting the like button. Bling! And if there is another look you'd like to see with the Mario palette, anything, literally, comment down below. I'd be happy to do so. I appreciate you watching. As always, be blessed and be kind. Real quick, all the drawers are closed. Good job, Holly. And we'll talk very soon. Bye.